Hi, I'm Fred. I'm a second year math student at Teddy Hall. I'm from North London. And today I'm going to be answering some questions and talking a little bit about what it's like to study maths at Teddy Hall and I guess Oxford in general. So the maths course is, unsurprisingly, very challenging. However, it's also very, very rewarding. It's very different to mathematics at school, where maybe the emphasis was on getting to an answer. And at Oxford, especially, there's a lot of opportunity to sort of go beyond and go further than what's in the course. Indeed, there's a large emphasis on proof and on verifying your results. The chance that you get in tutorials to discuss the mathematics is really, really exciting. And you get to, you know, really explore it to a level that you probably haven't before. I can honestly say as well that the tutors at Teddy Hall are really, really good at that. They're really good at answering our questions, and they're also really good at keeping us interested and letting us explore things further. And I think that's a really valuable thing to have. So I chose to study maths because I really liked maths. At school, I had always been interested in sort of maths, physics, engineering, computer science, that sort of area. And it was really when I qualified for the sort of the Mathematical Olympiad, and I got to sit that for the first time. And I thought, oh, this is really cool. Yeah, I mean, you know, things like solving quadratic equations or, you know, trigonometry, GCSE, that didn't particularly excite me. I was okay at it, but it didn't, you know, there was no excitement for me there. Whereas once I started seeing that actually maths was really creative and seeing the beautiful patterns and depths that there is to mathematics, that's what really excited me. And then as soon as I sort of started to research what a maths course might have in it and what it was about, I knew it was right for me. Okay, so personal statements for maths are not too important. That doesn't mean that you shouldn't write one or you shouldn't make it as good as you can though. In general, the rule, and this goes for all subjects, not just maths, is you want to show and not tell. So what that means is rather than say, oh, I really love maths, you can say, I've read this book, I've been to this lecture, and I've done this competition. Doing maths is a great thing, both for your personal statement and for your development as a mathematician. So if you can get involved in competitions and this sort of thing, that is one of the best ways you can show that you're interested. Also, you know, reading books about maths, popular math books and maybe textbooks, things outside of your A-level syllabus, all of that is gonna be good too. And obviously, sort of videos, online content. So we've got a tutor at Teddy Hall, Tom, who's got an awesome website and YouTube channel, Tom Rocks Maths. He runs various competitions there, so you might want to take part in those. He runs a yearly Teddy Rocks Maths essay competition, where you can submit an essay about mathematics, and that's a really good thing for your personal statement, and that's run by our tutor, Tom. There's also things like the Olympiad competitions, there's competitions like there's a Math Bomb competition, which is run by Manchester University. There's a Right Angle competition, which is run by Integral Maths. There's YouTube channels like Numberphile, 3Blue1Brown, all sorts of stuff. But the good news is that it isn't the make or break part of your application. But still, you want to make sure it's good. So yeah. So all applicants for mathematics and also all joint schools, so that's math and statistics, math and computer science, and math and philosophy, all have to sit the mathematics admissions test, the MAT. Now, the MAT is done, I think for me it was the 31st of October, which is a bit spooky, that's Halloween, but it's generally sat at the start of the year, and the content in the MAT is only AS pure maths. So it's quite basic content. However, the questions are quite tough and they really test your problem solving abilities. and your ability to think laterally, think outside the box. And indeed, that's obviously what Oxford wants to see. They want to see not just that you can integrate this function, differentiate this function, find, you know, sine of 45 without a calculator. They want to see that you can apply these sorts of things to problems that you haven't seen before. The math is quite hard. That's sort of the point. But the good news is there are lots and lots of past papers online, and that is the number one best way to prepare for it. And what's really important is that you should prepare early. If you're thinking about applying to Oxford for maths, the best time to do these math papers is over the summer, between year 12 and year 13. Maybe leave a few to do in that first half term of school, but really, you know, starting your preparation over the summer will stand you in really good stead. If you find that you've done all of those or you want something else, I can also recommend doing STEP papers. STEP is a different exam. That's the one that Cambridge uses. And they sit that at the end of the school year. And that generally has more advanced mathematical content in it. So it, you know, has the full A-level syllabus, and there's a paper on the further math syllabus as well. But it's still really useful for that outside-the-box problem-solving style of questions. And there are also STEP foundation modules you can find online, which have worksheets, which kind of can build you up to doing that. So I highly recommend that. But the number one thing is just do all the past papers. They're on the website with the mark schemes. There's absolutely no reason not to do them all. That's the best way you can prepare. Okay, so I had three interviews, and they took place on two consecutive days, but I actually stayed in Oxford for 4 days. So I arrived sort of midday one day, then the next day I had two interviews, the next day I had another interview, and then the next day I went home about midday. The interviews for all subjects, and maths is included in that, are technical and they are academic. They're not interviews like, you know, what's your worst quality as a person? What do you have for breakfast? What can you bring to our university? They are about mathematics. Indeed, it's very unusual to be asked a question about your personal statement in a mathematics interview. That doesn't mean it's impossible, but it's unusual. It's pretty much just going to be solving maths problems. Now, unsurprisingly, I hope they will be quite tough, and they may well be things that you haven't seen before, or are things that you have seen in a new context. That's sort of the point. And the idea is the tutors want to see how far you can get with their help. So they are very much expecting to have to ask you leading questions and prompt you and maybe correct you, help you if you get stuck. That's completely normal. And in fact, you know, if that doesn't happen, something strange has happened, but maybe you're a genius, but even geniuses seem to get stuck in Oxford maths interviews. They are tough, but that's sort of the point. I would say as much as you can, try and look forward to it. I think it is really exciting to have a chance to just sit down and talk maths, which hopefully is the thing that you love, with people who have made their whole career out of maths. You know, it's, you have their undivided attention for that space of time. And I think that's a really exciting thing. Lots of the questions you get asked are really quite cool and quite interesting. You know, certainly lots of the problems that I was asked, you know, made me think about things after my interview, which is very exciting. And whether you get in or not, I think it's a really awesome experience to have that undivided attention of these top academics. In terms of advice for the interview, I would say the best thing to do is as much as you can, just try and stay calm, try and keep your head. You are not going to be written off for like one small mistake. So for example, in my interview, I had to at one point take away 8 from 13, which I claimed was 7. Now it's not, but I said it was. And also at one point I pointed to 5 things and said, here's 4 numbers, and there were 5 numbers, and they were like, try again. And so I guess those sort of silly anecdotes kind of show that, you know, small tiny things aren't the problem. What they're looking at is how you approach a problem and how you think, and also, are you interested and curious and wanting to solve it? The worst thing you can try and do is second guess the interviewers and try and work out what's going on and this, that, and the other. All you can do is just try and stay calm, be yourself, and just tackle the problems in front of you as best you can. And it's really important to say that every time the interviewers, if they ask you a question or give you a hint or a prompt, really hang on to that, because there's a reason they've done that, and they might be trying to lead you somewhere and seeing where you can take it. Now, it's a weird experience having to talk through maths, right? Lots of us have done maths by ourselves, but often having to do it in front of someone and while narrating it and explaining it, it's quite tough. So if you have the experience to do that with someone, maybe a teacher or a friend or anything like that, I highly recommend that. If your schools can organise a practice interview, that will be awesome. But if they can't, that's completely okay. What you can do, and this is what I did, I just, when I was doing, say, my homework or when I was doing math papers, I was basically just out loud speaking what I was thinking and the solutions, which I guess probably meant my family thought I was a bit crazy, but was very helpful. I was literally sitting there going, okay, so when I, the discriminant is negative, so it's going to have no real roots, so I know my roots are a complex conjugate pair, and this, and you can just speak through what you're thinking, which is a really useful skill to have. Okay, so once you've got the offer, the hard work really is done. All that's left to do is to make the offer. Now, obviously, the offer for maths is 2 A stars in maths and verb maths and an A in a third subject. Now, if you've got an offer from Oxford to study maths, hopefully those grades shouldn't be, you know, unachievable. And indeed, the hope is that you do achieve them. So you want to, you know, keep your foot on the gas pedal, as it were, and make sure you do get those grades in your A levels. But other than that, there's not anything else that you really need to be doing while you're still in the school, other than just making sure you do get that offer. When I got my offer letter, I pinned it up right up here to motivate me to revise during my A levels in case I got lazy, which I'm known to do. And it was just, yeah, just sat right here. And that helped me kind of push through those last few months of school and get those grades to actually, you know, get to Oxford. Over the summer, there are a few things you can do if you want to. Yeah, you can start looking at the courses. There is a couple of nice books you can read, one by Richard Earle, who is sort of a big name in the maths department here. He done a book called Towards Higher Mathematics, which you might want to look at over the summer. The tutors may also send you a small amount of work, but really there's nothing you need to do other than just turn up with, you know, enthusiasm and excitement and get ready to be challenged, but also really rewarded for that. You know, the best thing you can do is have a nice relaxing summer, you know, see some friends, go traveling, whatever it is you like to do, and then get ready for what's going to be a tough but really enjoyable 3 or 4 years. Okay, well, it's been a while since I was actually in Teddy Hall, obviously, because of the pandemic. But I think I mentioned it earlier, the tutors at Teddy Hall for maths are fantastic. I really mean that. You know, I have friends at other colleges, and I've heard the way that they speak about their tutors and the things that their tutors do, and our tutors, the support we get from our tutors and how clear they are, how organized they are, they're just really, really good. We've got 3 sort of main tutors, which is Tom, Luke and Oliver, and we've also got a few PhD students. And they're all just absolutely fantastic. And I really think that the tutors for maths is what sets Teddy Hall apart. You know, Teddy Hall is obviously also a lovely college. It's a very nice place. It's sort of quite old and therefore quite quaint and quite cute. We've got a very cool library with a cool graveyard. Lots of stuff going on. We've got sport, music, drama, everything like that. But you can find that out you know, on our website and from these other talks. In terms of maths, it's our tutors that I think really make us awesome. Okay, so the number one piece of advice for math applicants is to just try and start doing maths that's not just your schoolwork. You know, whether that's you know, just trying to prove something that came up in class, if it's trying a competition, if it's going to a lecture, watching a video or number file, entering the Tom Rocks maths essay competition, anything at all. Just trying to do maths that's what we call, I guess, super curricular, which is, you know, outside of the school curriculum. because that is not only going to look really good on your application, but it also makes you a better mathematician. And you want to be doing these papers like STEP and MAT and these sorts of things, you know, and Olympiads and math challenges. These are what are going to really help you prepare for the various tests and interviews that you'll have. And they're also just really good in general to do as a young mathematician to develop and mature with your mathematics. So that's my piece of advice, is to try and do maths outside the curriculum as much as you can. And the second piece of advice is just enjoy doing maths. You know, try as much as you can to stay calm and keep a level head and just enjoy what you're doing. Stay focused. And yeah, look forward to university, where maths becomes so exciting, and it's like studying a completely different subject. So yeah. So thank you very much, everyone. I hope that was enjoyable and helpful. Be sure to follow SEH Access on Instagram for more information, and feel free to ask questions there, and they can get in touch. So yeah, thank you very much, and I'm signing off. Bye bye.